I just wanted to ask you about the situation in the Balkans and their European perspective. What do you think of the latest progress reports Commissioner Fiule presented and the change of approach?
First of all, I think this year could be still crucial for some countries of the Western Balkans. We have seen some progress, especially when it comes to Serbia or Kosovo. The other is as well Albania, where we just recently had elections which were fair and democratic. So I think there are some progresses after the joining of Croatia of European Union. The reports overall were not negative. Of course, there is a lack of progress when we talk about Bosnia and Herzegovina. There is a lack of progress when we talk about Macedonia. But I would like to see especially that on the side, not only of the governments of the Western Balkans, which really have to push the European reforms, but as well on the side of European governments to remain credible and really do everything to help the region, because we gave a lot of promises and we have to fulfill them as well when it comes to European perspective. I think for me it's very important, especially coming from the region, that we do really everything to help the countries to join the European Union as soon as possible and strengthen this area.
Do you think the European Commission has learned all the lessons from previous enlargements, especially the lessons from Bulgaria and Romania?
Of course, we learned good and bad lessons. For Bulgaria and Romania, many people would say, and many politicians, that the decision was too political, and of course that because of these two countries we suffered some sort of enlargement fatigue. But I still believe that enlargement is extremely important project, because it is not about only stability and the progress and economic and political reforms. It is as well about the cooperation. When we talk about the region of the Western Balkan, all these reforms are needed for the countries. And I just believe that when we once are in the process of the accession and negotiations, we really do help and benefit to both sides.
Now the Commission is a changing approach, and given the economic situation in all the countries in the region, do you think it's a good idea that the Commission proposes the European semester to somewhat enter into the enlargement process, to be taken into account their economic situation?
I think it is extremely important what Commission did after the Croatia's enlargement, that they are reopening first chapters like 23 and 24. These are most demanding chapters, fight against corruption, organized crime. These chapters so far in the negotiations were the last ones, and countries needed a lot of time. Today, when it comes to these most difficult issues, countries of the Western Balkan are better prepared. So that is very important approach of the Commission, or high-level dialogues, to try, even if the negotiation hasn't started yet, but to try to do everything to prepare countries for the very demanding path ahead.
Do you think there should be more focus on the economy?
Certainly, economy is today a very difficult issue. All the countries are facing severe difficulties. The unemployment somewhere is very high. And economic issues, I mean, the whole Europe is today in economic and financial crisis. These are joint efforts we all have to do, and to help the Western Balkan, which is anyway a more poverty region, it's certainly very useful.
Thank you very much.